Good evening to all and all present here. I am Sonalika Paul of NIT Agartala and I have worked in the Spoken Tutorial project of IIT Bombay. So let me start my presentation by introducing my team members. Myself, Sonalika Paul, and we have Ruhita Shreddipalli from NIT Suratkal. Our mentors are Kirti Amre ma'am and Nancy Varke ma'am. I'm very thankful to them for their constant support and technical help throughout the project. And our work is associated with the CD content module of the Spoken Tutorial project. Now about the Spoken Tutorial project, it is an open source project that is an initiative of NME ICT, that is National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology. It is launched by MHRD Government of India and it is developed by IIT Bombay Spoken Tutorial team. The main aim of this website is to promote IT literacy and propagate the use of open source software through audio-video tutorials. It has approximately 6,500 plus video tutorials in 28 languages. So in the Spoken Tutorial website, we have a create your own disk image feature, which lets the user to download the tutorials and play them in the offline mode. So once they are downloaded, they can be played when there is no internet connection. So this is especially beneficial to the students of rural areas where internet and computing resources are very limited. So once they are downloaded, they can be shared among the students. So the UI of the offline mode closely resembles the online mode, except some of the features. So the first feature that is missing is that the questions that are posted on the forum website are not displayed along the tutorial list. So we have added this feature. So how have we done it? We have first fetched the question from the database, then we have sent the context to Django template, then we have rendered the template and converted to a dynamic HTML file. Finally, we add the file to the zip. Here in this form, you can see we first select the FOSS category, the level and the language. Then when we click on add selected FOSS and create zip file, a link is generated. On clicking this link, a zip format, a folder will be downloaded in zip format. When we extract the zip format, a folder called spoken will be created, and in that an index.html file will be there, which we should click to search and watch the video tutorials. So here we can see that beside the video, the questions of the forums are posted. So the next feature that was missing is that on clicking a question, a new page should open which will contain the answers to those questions. So we have added even that feature. For that, we have run a loop for each of the questions and then fetched the answers from the database. After that, we have sent the context to Django template. The template will then display the answers in a particular format with a proper CSS. Then the template is being converted to a dynamic HTML file. So finally, for each of the questions of a particular tutorial, a new file will be created and that file will be added to the zip. So here we can see the page that opens on clicking a particular question. First, the question is being displayed and then followed by its answers. So the third feature that we have worked upon is to sync the questions with the time that they were posted. The questions that were posted at a particular time will get highlighted, that is their background color will turn gray and will be scrolled to the top. For the rest of the questions, the background color will still be white. So to do this, we have a function on YouTube iframe API ready, which is being called by the YouTube API. So that function adds an onReady event listener. So in that listener, we first check if the current time is less than the duration. If it is yes, then we call a trigger function. In the trigger function, the background color of those questions which is posted during that range is changed to gray and is scrolled to the top. And for the rest of the answers, background color is white and scroll to top is set to false. So here you can see that these questions are the ones which were posted during that time and they got highlighted. So another thing that we have done is making this script which highlights the question based on their time, compatible with the AVS player. So for the successful completion of another project, which was given to another team of FOSSI interns, it was required to change the player from the existing VideoJS to AVS player. So we have also worked on making it compatible with AVS player. So every project has a future scope. So in our project, we were thinking about posting of offline posting of the answers. So we have achieved up to storing the username, password, and the answers in the JSON format. But the sending of those data when the internet connectivity is gained is an area where future work can be done. That's all for the presentation. Now we'll show you the demo of the project. In the spoken folder, we have seen that there is a file index.html. On clicking this file, we'll get this page. So this is all downloaded. We select the FOSS and the language, and then the list is shown of tutorials. When we click a particular tutorial, we get this tutorial list. We can see here that the questions are being posted. On clicking a question, we see that the new page is opened, which contains the answers and the question of that page. So that's it. Thank you.
Is there a concept of, say, incremental downloads? Say, if you have already downloaded, say, one day before, and today some new updates have come, so you like to download it again.
Sir, actually,
how do you handle it?
Actually, it is once we are able to implement the future scope, that is getting on with the internet connection. We basically faced a problem in creating, in getting the internet connection, sir, because there were too many files we had to understand because it was a already existing code. So once we get to know that, then we'll be able to do this also, sir. This is also one of the thing which we can do because answers keep getting posted every now and then. So this is also a future scope.
Thank you, sir.